trusted friend.
And it just goes to show how precious life is and how fast things can change in your lives.
Beautiful South Freeport, Long Island. Hi, it's Manny, and I'm out and about here on a beautiful February afternoon on the beach here in Calmetto Park in South Freeport, and I'm freezing because there's a lot of wind. But I'm here to prove a point that most of us go to an office to work or a facility, but this was Cory's office, and this is where Cory made his living, here in the bays of South Freeport and in the vicinity, doing what a bayman does. And it didn't matter what kind of weather it was, but Cory would be out there on the water doing what he's got to do to make a living, and this was prime time for him. It didn't matter that it was cold and windy, but the true bayman that Cory was, his heart was always out here on the bay.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. But in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Tell the story about when you first met Cory.
That'll work.
Oh, when I first met Cory, I was working in a bar called The Sportsman, which is no longer there. And
we all know The Sportsman.
He was the first person to walk through the door, check out the fresh meat, as he would say. And he came in and he helped me set up, and we talked. And as the years, it was a good year and a half or so that we were friendly, and he used to bring me soup and things like that, and I went into the walk-in and I got the roses, and all the card said was, "I love you, the crab," and I had no idea who the crab was.
Wow.
And in the meantime, we became more and more friendly and talked a lot, and eventually he just came to me and told me, I love you, and if you give me a chance, I will make you the happiest person. And not all the times were good, but we had a lot of good times, and he has always made me very, very happy.
Just get an idea from you, Betty, you know, what kind of stuff is going to be in the book, and, you know, pictures and people that, and their experiences that they had with Cory. They're going to write about that. Just give us an overview of what kind of stuff we should expect to see in the book.
What we're working on is thenewsday.com in the obituary section has a location called View Guest Book. Mm-hmm. You can go on that location and write either to Priscilla, to Colin, to Cory, or just something that you want to say from your heart. I use it as a therapeutic agent as well.
Mm-hmm.
What we're going to do with that is, once we give people a little more time to write what they want to write on it, we're going to turn it into a legacy book. Mm-hmm. That book's going to contain everything that's written on that guest book on Newsday.com, in addition to some artwork, which Stephen Parker is helping us with, mm-hmm. and some pictures that we want Priscilla and Colin to have forever on their coffee table. When they can read it for comfort. Again, I encourage everybody to please, now that we're coming up on a year, get on that website and write your heart out, because it will be a permanent remembrance for Priscilla and Colin and all of us in a community that's extremely close. And losing Cory was losing our captain of the Crick.
And, you know, we did, you know, any number of, you know, recorded interviews. And, you know, the first thing we did together was a maritime festival. It was the first thing that had actually happened, even though there was, like, the beginnings of what now is the Nautical Festival. And so we did that. And then we thought, well, gee, maybe he could go into a classroom and teach some kids about this. And there was this really great person in the school district, and before you know it, he had captive audience, and he just came to life. You know, telling everybody what he did, all the, you know, going eeling and crabbing, the kind of boats that he used, working on the ET and some of the dragger boats, and all the people he learned from. And he just opened his heart to not only me, but to anybody he came in contact with. I think, you know, that's what everybody will remember.
Well, I met Cory when I was 10 years old, actually. Mm-hmm. And that was when he was living just south of Atlantic. I was hanging out with Lorna, and that was the first time I met Cory. And of course, he had fishing pole in hand, and he was rushing out the door, mm-hmm. jumped on his damn stingray, and he was gone. And I always thought that, I was like, wow, who is that guy, you know? And little by little, I got to know him, and he taught me really cool things, like how you could take the reeds of grass at low tide and stick them in the holes on the marshes, and all the crabs would come out. So he taught me how to collect all my own bait and everything. I mean, I knew Cory forever. Mm-hmm. The biggest voice I've ever known in my life, and always will be. But I think I took on being a trustee for the Colin A. Weyant Trust, because Cory would say to me all the time, and he'd reiterate the same story all the time, ah, damn kid of mine. I'm out in the water with him today, and the kid says, you know, Pop, I want to be just like you. I want to do the same thing. Hmm. And he said, Squid, you're going to school.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend. We've known each other since we were 9 or 10. Together we've climbed hills and trees, learned of love and ABC, skinned our hearts and skinned our knees. Goodbye, my friend, it's hard to die when all the birds are singing in the sky. Now that the spring is in the air, pretty girls are everywhere.